Hi guys, I'm back again with an example of charge distribution on three plates, which I've already discussed that I'll come up with that example. We've already discussed the example of two plates, but today we will discuss the example of charge distribution on three plates with grounding. Okay, so let's go. So this is a case in which we have three plates, whatsoever be the distance between them. I am repeating myself that whatsoever be the distance between them. By that I mean that either the distance between them may be equal or may be not equal. It doesn't matter. Initially it doesn't matter. So I am telling my thing again that the distance between the plate doesn't matter here initially. Okay. Now, if this plate, middle plate, is being given some charge Q, then we all know that how to distribute this Q charge on the system, that we will add up this charge and we will divide this charge into two equal parts. So the charge distributed will be like this. This will be Q by 2, this will be Q by 2, this will be minus Q by 2, this will be plus Q by 2 on this surface, this will be plus Q by 2 as their sum should be equal to Q, and this will be minus Q by 2 as their sum should be equal to 0. So this will be the charge distribution on the plates when both the switches are open and both the plates are not grounded. And this charge distribution doesn't depend on the fact that plates are equally spaced or not, provided that the space between the plates is very small. Okay. Now, what will happen if we close one of the switch? So let us suppose we closes the switch S1. When S1 is closed, then I am demonstrating this with three possibilities, which will be in the mind of a student. Then the three cases would be like this. In case 1, he can think that all of the charge of the center plate is induced on that side, this is neutral, and minus Q is induced at this side and plus Q is induced at that side, and its charge becomes 0. Now there are some problem in this type of charge distribution, that at some point P here, you can see the electric field due to this charge is towards left side, due to this charge is towards right side, and they will cancel out with each other, and there would be a remaining electric field due to Q towards left side, which is also not possible because we know that the electric field inside a conductor is 0. Now, this possibility is not correct, hence. Case B. Case B is a possibility which a student can think that there will be no distribution of charge on any of the plate, and Q will remain on the center plate and both of these plates will remain neutral. Again, this is a wrong distribution, as the electric field at point P is non-zero. This plate will create an electric field here. Okay, as it is having some charge Q. So this is a wrong. Electric field at P is not zero. Electric field at P is not zero. In case C, in this type of distribution, in the total charge of this plate appears on its left side, and induced equal and opposite charge appears on the right side of this plate, and this plate remains neutral. Now, we can cross check this distribution, that at point P, P might be inside this plate or this plate or this plate, the electric field at point P is zero. You can see that this charge will attract any positive charge placed at P, and this charge will repel any positive charge which is placed at P. So net electric field at P would be 0. As well as We know that by grounding any metal, we are keeping its potential to be zero. So it is very necessary that the potential of grounded metal should be zero, which is not zero in this case. If you can see that the potential of this plate should be zero, but this plate will be influenced by these two plates. As this is a neutral plate, net charge is zero. Hence, its potential on this plate is zero. That is okay. But this is not a neutral plate. Hence, its potential will not be zero on this plate. And this plate is neutrally self, then its self potential will be zero. Hence, the net potential at the point P, or the potential of this plate, will be non-zero. And it would be non-zero due to this plate. So this is incorrect, because potential should be zero, it is grounded. Now in this case, you can also see that the potential of this plate is not zero due to the potential induced due to this plate. Now in this case, the potential of this plate due to self charge minus Q is equal and opposite to potential of this plate due to that charge plus Q. We are assuming that the potential of these plates are same on the other plates also, because we also know that the formula for potential of conducting plates is not defined. But if we assume that the potential of this plate due to self charge is V, then its potential on this plate will also be V, due to the fact that they are very closely kept to each other. So in this case, we can say that the potential of this plate, net potential, is zero and it is grounded. So it is correct distribution that if you have closed the switch S1, which is that of left plate, then its complete charge of the middle plate will appear on the left side, and the Q flown charge from the ground will be minus. And if we have closed this switch only, and we have kept open this switch, then this charge will appear completely on right side, and there will be a induced charge minus Q here. Q flown will be minus Q, and this plate will remain neutral. Similarly, like this, these are symmetrical switches. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and keep watching for more unique concepts. Thank you.